Hello. The discipline of geography, when we start this subject, something which we have to undergo is understanding the basic geography. Before we take the optional as a subject, we will be in conflicting debate that whether I have taken the right optional, do I fit in? And many times it is seen that people who have done some different degrees or other undergrads, they opt for geography because it is the most as I mentioned, is most interesting and most definitely scoring when you are, aware of the terminologies and basic concept. And it's just one storyline which and gives has some great perspectives. Once you're aware of that and it goes with your own personality, it allows you to enrich. And in fact, people who are looking at how that they some one subject which supplements the GS preparation, essay preparation, and subject that option comes out as geography. Because all the disciplines which we see today has actually come out from geography. As I mentioned previously, that even medical science can be considered as coming out from geography itself. There were two subjects initially when it started in the European or ancient European time, history and geography. History was something which spoke about the timeline, geography which included the space as well. So that's how it started. Today the session is going to focus on the basic concept of understanding the growth of the discipline or basic geography. What happens is when we see that many students will see that they are not able to score well when they write in the mains. The basic reason is that even if you are an engineer or you are a non-geography background student, the examiner who is going to check your answer expects a minimum geographical perspective in the scenario. And a geographical perspective only happens when you understand the history or the people who have contributed to make it as a discipline. One needs to understand who and how many people or where does that come in and how the perspective have built to make it as an academic discipline and which is continuing till today. So we need to understand the pedagogy, that how did the discipline of geography start. While all of us can identify to the fact that geography is a need in daily life. When I travel, I need maps to travel. When it comes to map, I need coordinates. When I need coordinates, I need to understand latitude, longitude. So all this aspect is there which we do daily life impact of geography happens. So that's applicative. So now let's go through the development of the discipline of geography. The geography by Gilbert F. White, it says that geography is a discipline concerned with understanding the spatial dimensions of environmental and social process. While Saar says that may a preselective bent towards geography be recognized before it asserts itself as deliberate election. The first, let me say, most primitive and persistent trait is liking maps and thinking by means of them. We are empty-handed without them in lecture room, in study, in the field. Show me a geographer who does not need them constantly and want them about him, and I shall have my doubts as to whether he has made the right choice of life. Now this comes very critical statement. I would actually give an example of, as I mentioned about maps. I'm sure most of you, while navigating their way, use Google Maps. While using an Uber or any cab services, definitely maps becomes critical. So maps, utilization of maps has become so integral that in fact, one of the major product which Google plays around is Google Earth. And I'm sure that while many of you would have never seen a planet Earth from actual space, but they would have definitely seen it in Google Earth. How does it look from outside? So one of the first, as I mentioned, geographer's first contribution, the first subject discipline's element was maps. And this is one of the first ancient European map which was mapped about how the world is spaced. So this was the work of Ptolemy in 1482, map of Germany based on the Ptolemy's work. Again, a German map. Again, with the, I'm sure all of you must be aware that there was an age of European discovery where Portuguese, Spanish, and English, they started voyaging across the globe, finding new continents, finding new places, and that's where the importance of maps came in. That number one was because they were traveling through ocean, so movement of ocean, movement of wind, movement of sun, and everything was a discipline to be understood before they could venture into it. I'm sure all of you must be aware of Vasco da Gama coming to India, then James Cook or the Captain Cook, and for Diodoro de Magalhães, who actually traveled around the globe. So basically, this is very clearly mentioned that the importance of map and the ocean, how it has busy or how it has actually contributed everybody in the discovery of discipline. Just as a case study, in December 14, 1911, the Norwegian party actually went to know the actual pole, North Pole, to put a tent over there, to figure out. One of the most important names or superstars of geography or geographer is Alexander von Humboldt. Please remember the name. He himself has contributed immensely in various aspects of geography with his history of being a traveler and explorer. He has traveled, one of the first geographer who has traveled across the globe to find new elements which could be credited as a subject in geography. So he, in his book Geography of Plants in Tropical Countries, he is credited to find or know more about in detail of South America. And we would learn about it when we go in optional about various perspective of geography and geographers. So today, as a basic thing, this name as an object name, Alexander Humboldt. Similarly, Charles Darwin's voyage of HMS Beagle in 1831-36 is also credited to the knowledge of geography to find out his concept of life or survival of fittest. Charles Darwin himself went to various places, as you can see in the map, to actually give his theory a confidence of relevant specimens and relevant proof, so that he could bring to or give the world the theory of or survival of the fittest concept. So with the relevance of geography becoming very, very critical in the as a subject and as a most elemental thing before any discoveries or voyages. Usually what happens is the discipline is grown as a society, and you would see that across the globe various foundation of societies, geographical societies initiated in the 18th, 19th century. And this is important when we understand the continent-wise impact of geography and how these studies have been come together. So, in fact, in 1874, the erstwhile Prussia actually establishes chair of geography in every university. So that was the criticality of the discipline, that every university needs to have geography as a subject. In 1887, the first reader in geography appointed at Oxford University in the United Kingdom. And in 1903, University of Chicago establishes first department of geography in the US. Also, it started the Association of American Geographers, AAG, and it continues to do many contribution to the geography with its annual meeting, which has been happening. So this is the current information. George Perkins Marsh, and in his book Man and Nature, or Physical Geography as Modified by Human Action, highlighted the connection between geography and current lifetime. He mentioned that there are parts of Asia Minor, of Greece, even of Alpine Europe, where the operation of causes set in action by man has brought the face of the earth to a desolation almost as complete as that of the moon. The earth is becoming an unfit home for its noblest inhabitant. And today, when we talk of climate change and various other factors, you would realize that this statement made in 1864 means a lot. So you can understand that the geography is not the outcome of an instance, but a studies of lot of observation and lot of studies to which these environment specialists or climate geographers works. Environmental determinism, as I said, these are the, when we talk of geography as a discipline, we need to include really, really good geographers' name. We need to know their work. We need to know how they have influenced. Friedrich Ratzel and Ellen Churchill Semple. You will have to quote such names who have done contribution and whose work today is seen as a reality. You will see when you talk of understanding more towards environment geography or climatology and what are the perspectives, you will have to understand. So we will go through it when we do the optional. So these are certain names. Similarly, one of the greatest names of the theory or proponent of possibilism, Paul Vidal Laplace. So he is a French geographer, and when you understand how the theories have come, you know, the best part of this geography is when it has its academic inputs, that how something evolves as a perspective from the previous ones and how it adds a new element to it. So one story. So if we see that the phase one of the geography as a discipline had mostly talking about exploration of the world with discovery of mapping and all that around that, the voyages and that, those elements. Second came because this was happening, every university, every study places, they wanted to have to make it as a study unit, establishment of the discipline, and that's how it was bringing the nature or the earth or all the aspect of it, physical aspect of it, and connecting with human, and then the environment part, the early theories of environmentalism. Then came with, as France came in picture, Germany came in picture, and various other geography destination, UK came in picture, the regional geography came into more region-wise, the importance and the relevancy and the detailed mapping, detailed stories of each area was understood or developed. And then came that let's have the approach or the scientific approach of taking it as a science came the emergence of physical and human geography. And we will understand like the theory of evolution with the time period. You will realize that how that's a line of linkages of stories of how things have evolved, because nobody was there to witness the entire journey of how Earth was formed till what we see today. So these are all proponents of various proofs which are there, and then these beautiful brains work together to create a perspective how things could have come. So it looks like more of a discipline of search and theories to, you know, so is it the right thing, or are we just assuming something? So we call this as a hypothesis, and many of these hypotheses turn into theories because similar proof has been established at various part of the continent, and that's how the discipline came. And today we see that the geography has a clear distinction of elements within it as a physical geography and an integrated geography which brings them together, and human geography. And then, you know, we go by like when we are in India, so we want to understand India with the respective of physical geography, understand it with respective of human geography. So similarly, the development of geography as a discipline across the globe has taken, and this is one of the most key phases of development of geography as discipline. So the development of geography as a discipline is still continuing, and it will continue. So we'll see in the 1960s, the quantitative revolution started, where the regional geography was spoken with the name of numbers. And then in 1980s, with space age coming into picture, you will see that remote sensing, GIS, these topics came in between. And today we are going more towards specialized geography at various disciplines. And with the incorporation of technology, you will see that the basic foundation is geography. And slowly, slowly, the technology-driven elements are adding to the relevancy of the subject. So, with a little bit of quote to ponder, today's session, the last quote by Mark Twain, God created war so that Americans would learn geography. I'm sure all of you would be watching movies, watching, playing games. You will realize that how critical the geography or the space of that event is. So with this, I would like to end that this chapter is basically from the basics which we learn, and we start geography optional with having some foundation. I hope you are able to create a good picture of how the discipline has evolved from the time. And we learn more about in detail when we learn about perspective of geography. And that's how the inputs of getting a geographer's perspective and bringing out it in the UPSC examination helps. So looking forward to learn together. Thank you.